Hey, Andy here from Andy's Tech Tutorials. Now in this video I'm going to show you how you can use the boards view or the boards feature in Outlook on the web. So this is the Office 365 version of Outlook and in particular the calendar element. So boards is a relatively new addition to Outlook and it's actually really useful. Essentially what boards allow you to do is to create a new board where you can view and you can organize all of your things like calendars, task lists, sticky notes, links, goals, reminders, or attachments in one place. So if you have a lot of those going on and you need to see them all at one time, then what you can essentially do is create a board and then have all of that content displayed in one place. So let me show you how to use boards in Outlook. Now, I am currently in Outlook just now on Office 365, and I want to show you how we can view a board and its elements and then create our own new board and add some elements to that. If you open up Outlook, 9 times out of 10, you will get taken into the mail part of Outlook. So what we want to do is we want to now go into Calendar. I'm going to click on the Calendar button on the left-hand side, and then you'll see you get taken to the standard calendar view. Now it'll always take you in when you're logged in and you change between Outlook and calendar and directory and whatnot. It will always take you back into your kind of the last view you had. So in this case I've just got the day view for my calendar. If I had the monthly view and I was still logged in and I moved back to Outlook then back to calendar, it would bring me back in to the monthly view. So what we want to do is we want to go where it says day just at the top right here. We are going to change it to board. So you'll see you've got day, work week, week, month. They're all the kind of the views that you're used to. And you'll see we have now have board down the bottom here. Now you can either click on board or you can go to the more arrow and you'll see you've actually got the option to create new boards. So you get a default board view, but you can also create different boards, which is handy if you want to only view certain elements but be able to flick between them. So what we'll do is we'll just click on board or default. They both do the same thing. And this will take us to the default board view. So when you go into board view for the first time, you will have a couple of different elements here. Now the way it basically works is you have this one view and then you can add different pieces or things to your board. So the first part is we have the calendar element here. So you'll see if I click on the down pointer next to calendar, you can choose which calendar to display. You can add additional calendars. You can even rename it here. So instead of it saying calendar, I could have whatever I want. If I click on the pencil, I can change that. Obviously calendar makes sense, so I'm happy to leave that there. It might be something like a work calendar. So we could change that to work calendar. And then we could add another one for personal if we wanted to. You can change the date range here. So we have, we're looking at this week, the 20th, but we could jump ahead to maybe March if we wanted to and open up another view and you'll see we've got the March view. You can jump between weeks here. And if you want to, you can click on today and you can go back to today. Up here, you'll see we've got the more options for this calendar element and you can change it from the 4-day view that I've got here. You'll see you can pick how many days you want to view ahead. So we could do 6 days or we could change that to maybe even just the work week, which is defined in the settings for your actual calendar. In this case, it's a standard Monday to Friday, 9 to 5 is the work week. But of course that would change if you had changed that. And you'll see we can then, if we want to, we can change it to week. We'll have the full week view. So you can also add events from here. So if you had to add something in, what you can do is you can just click where you want to add that event. And then I'll put in new meeting. Let's just leave it as it is, click save. And you'll see we've managed to add in a new event. And you can do things like expand the duration of the meeting and change the start and end times from within here. And of course it's all linked to your main calendar. So if you make changes in here, they will be pulled across to your main calendar. So here you'll see you can move up and down and you can also resize. So you basically have almost like this grid page where you can pop these elements and then you can just resize them to fit. Now you'll see I can't make this one smaller because we've got the week view. So what I would need to do is just change the view back to something like, if I just do a 2-day one, you'll see it narrows it and I can resize. So these elements can be moved around and they can be resized. The next one along here, you'll see we have tasks. So this works with your standard task list. So you'll see you can see tasks in general, or if you have any for your particular day that you are viewing. In here, you can also add tasks. So if I was to say I needed to, get the shopping, so get shopping, I'll add that task, and that now becomes a task in this list. I could do something like, so collect dog from vets, I'll add that one, and I'll do one final one, so post parcel, click add. So they are now all tasks, and if I went into tasks on the left hand side here in to do, those would actually appear there. And of course you can mark them as favorites so that those appear as favorites within the tasks area. You'll see you can also use a resize option in here if you want to, and this one's really long, but I might want to just narrow it down so I can just make it a little bit smaller, which allows me then to maybe take an element such as note here, and you'll see you can click and drag and we can put notes in here as well. So notes works in the same way, you can resize it, you can type a note. And of course the good thing about the notes is they are available in other Office 365 applications. So you can view your notes when you're in the mail element of Outlook, where you're typing an email, you can actually open your notes in there. And as well as that, if you're using something like OneNote, your notes will be available in there too. So the notes just work by typing in your notes. So your note goes here, and then you'll see what you can do is you can do basic formatting, you can put pictures, and there's a couple of options here where you can do things like set due dates for your notes, and sometimes people like to change the color of the notes to have different notes for different things. So that's a little bit about adding the notes. Now you'll see you get tips here, you can move these around. I like to go to three dots and just use remove, which now takes that out. So that's how we can basically look at some of the elements which are already on the default board. What you want to do if you want to add any new elements is go up to add to board, and then you'll see you can add any of these things. So let's say, for example, I wanted to add a file attachment to this board. Maybe it's like a file that I'm constantly updating every day. So what I can do is I can click on file, and then you'll see it links to my OneDrive space for the account I'm logged into. And in there I have this PDF, so I'm going to use that one as my example. I'll click next, and then what you'll see is it adds that file to there. So obviously it's a PDF, I'm not updating that one on a daily basis, but it could be that I just need to check the contents of that file on a daily basis to, remind myself of certain things I have to do. If it was a Word file, then I could make updates to it on a regular basis. But that's how you can add an element there. And the nice thing is anything that you add, you see you can just click and drag. So you can move your board around and have it laid out however you want. So you could essentially have the calendar in the middle here, and then you could have things like all of your notes down the side, or your notes could run all the way underneath. Up in the add to board menu, you can also go to show all, and you see there's a few other things. So you might even just want to have something like a clock. So if I put Edinburgh here, then you'll see it gives me the time in Edinburgh, and it could be that I'm working with people from other countries. So maybe I need to add something like Amsterdam. So their time zone is slightly different. So you see it's 10 past 12. And then I'll just do New York as a final example. So you'll see it's 6 in the morning there. So you could have your clock just displayed so that when you're quickly looking at your tasks, you can glance over and you'll know what time it is in different locations across the world. Now, once you've laid your content out and you're happy with it, what you can do is you can click on Lock Board. And what this means is you can't then move the elements around. So if I try and drag this, you'll see it doesn't move. This one is stuck. Oops, I've just opened that attachment. This one is now stuck there. So by locking the board, elements are restricted or are basically glued to the page. So I tend to set mine up when I'm happy with it, I then lock it, and I know that nothing's going to move and nothing's going to change. What you can do if you want to create another view is you can go to the board, down to board, down to the more option arrow, and then go down to new board, and then within here you give it a name. So this could be personal, and then I can go to create, and then you get another new board. So again, it gives you the default items, but this time I might want to change the calendar to I don't know, let's just do United Kingdom holidays and take off this calendar. So we could pretend this is my personal calendar. I'm going to remove tasks from here. I'm going to remove notes and I'm going to remove tips. And then in here, I'm just going to add in, let's just add in a goal. So what is my goal? So my goal is to, lose 10 pounds. And I'm going to set my goal date. So then I can do something like, say by the end of, end of January. And you'll see we now have this goal. So I've got 42 days to lose this weight. And then when I'm done, what I can do is I can mark it as completed with the little tick. And then I might want to maybe add in some notes. So I could just say something like, so weight on December and then, December the 20th, and I could put in what my weight is. And then I could just update that as I go along so I could keep track. And I might want to do something like go to add to board and go to task list. And then what I'll do is I'm going to add a new task which says something like weigh myself. And I can make sure I just add that in. So then I can tick myself off once I've weighed myself. So I could make that a task that each week, and I could put the date next to that. So it could actually be weigh myself week commencing 27th of December. And then I could make another one down here for weigh myself week commencing, I can't even think what the date is, but let's just say 3rd of Jan. So then I've got these tasks in here, and then I could just work through them as I need to. So again, I would lock that one, and that's now there. And now that you've created two boards, when you go into where it says personal here, because that's my personal board, if I jump down to the more board option here, I can see the default one and I can see my personal. So if I want to jump back to the default view, I then just jump back just like that. So you'll see here if you want to as well, you can use this little option to expand the calendar, and it lets you just jump between different dates for your calendar rather than using these options here. So the board can be a really, really nice way of pulling everything together that you commonly use in Outlook to do with like your calendar, your tasks, your notes, and just have them in one place. I've certainly found that from a working perspective, this works really, really well. I'm able to see my tasks for the week. I can have the clock view so I can see when different people that I liaise with are going to likely be in the office. And of course, I can get my full calendar for work in there, so I'm able to see what appointments I have for my day. But obviously, it depends how you want to set this up. But I think it's a really, really good addition to Outlook 365, this particular element. So that's the overview of the boards feature in Microsoft Office for the web. Hopefully you guys found that useful. If you did, please do consider giving it a like and comment below. Let me know what you thought of this video or what you think of boards in general. Is it a feature that you use, or are you not too fussed about it? And if you do use it, which elements do you tend to add to your board? If you've not already subscribed to my channel, please do consider subscribing and click on that notification bell so you'll be notified about any future videos that I release. But anyway, thanks again for watching.